So Antony's capital account debtor 45,000. 2. Amar's capital. 2. Akbar's capital. Here we are not opening the goodwill account. Instead of that, we are adjusting it from the new partner's capital account. Hope this is clear to all. Now this one, the next one is already discussed. Still we'll go through it. New partner brings in only a part of his goodwill in cash, not the full amount. Only a part is brought by the new partner. So we have two entries when the goodwill is brought. When capital and goodwill is brought, we give the journal entry cash account debtor to goodwill to new partner's capital account. Okay, whatever amount of goodwill is brought by him, and the goodwill brought by him actually, that is distributed from goodwill account itself, goodwill account debtor, then the rest of the amount, pending amount, is taken from new partner's capital account. So goodwill account debtor, new partner's capital account debtor to old partner's capital account. Remember this problem doing in the class yesterday, I mean the previous day? Yes. The same question, A and B are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share. The new profit sharing ratio is also given. C brought 50,000 for his capital. So as capital, he is bringing 50,000. And his share of goodwill is 15,000. But out of this 15,000, only 10,000 is brought by him. Okay, he is bringing only 10,000 out of this 15,000. So that, for that we will create a goodwill account, and the rest of the amount which is not brought by him, the pending amount 5,000, that is given from his new partner's capital account. That is a new partner's capital. Who's the new partner? C. Okay, this is already worked out problem in the class, only the names are different. Here I have given A and B. There was a similar problem in the textbook. Okay, so we have three journal entries here. Cash account debtor to C's capital, that is bringing capital. The capital is brought by the new partner. Then next one, the entries are given separately. Either you can give it, combine it and give a combined journal entry, but here as different, two different journal entries are given. Cash account debtor to capital account, that means goodwill brought. How much is the goodwill brought? 10,000 only is brought, 5,000 is pending. So whatever is brought, goodwill account debtor 10,000, then C's capital account debtor 15,000 minus 10,000. Okay, that's all about revaluation method. Now we are moving to a new topic, that is hidden goodwill. Okay, goodwill is hiding, hidden goodwill. Now what is hidden goodwill? Let's see what is hidden goodwill. Hidden goodwill means value of goodwill that is not specified at the time of admission of a partner. Okay, the goodwill is not specified. Even the share of the new partner, how much a share of goodwill the new partner has to bring, that is also not specified, not mentioned. Okay, so we need to find out how much is the goodwill. what is the share of the new partner, how much the new partner should bring. So no information is given about the goodwill that the new partner has to bring. So in such a situation, it has to be inferred. That means we have to find it out from the arrangement of capital. We are going to arrange the capital and profit sharing ratio in such a way that we get the goodwill amount. And for that, this is the way to do it: calculation of goodwill account. Calculation of goodwill account. So first step is to find out what is the total capital of the new firm. Okay, new firm means after including the new partner, it becomes a new firm. Okay, so find out the total capital of the new firm. So what is the total capital? To find out that, new partner's capital, whatever the capital is brought by the new partner, new partner's capital into reciprocal of his share. Reciprocal means what? Reciprocal means, what is a reciprocal? Reciprocal means putting the ratio upside down. If 2 by 5 is the ratio, what is the reciprocal of 2 by 5? It becomes 5 by 2. Reciprocal means the numerator becomes the denominator, denominator becomes the numerator. Okay? Again, what is the reciprocal of 1 by 4? What is the reciprocal of 1 by 4? Shubham, what is the reciprocal of 1 by 4? 4 by 1, right, okay. So, new partner's capital into reciprocal of his share. This is how we are going to find out the total capital of the new firm. Then, from that, we need to less a particular amount, that is, find out actual capital of all partners. What is the actual capital contribution made by all partners? That is deducted from the total capital. Thus, we get the hidden goodwill. This is how we find out hidden goodwill. Let's see a problem, then you will understand more of it. Hari and Nikhil are partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio 3:2. Okay, so old ratio 3:2. Their capitals were, whose capital? Hari and Nikhil's capital. 80,000 and 50,000 respectively. Okay, they admitted Soman as a new partner for 1 by 5. Soman's capital, how much is Soman's capital? It is 60,000 and his share is given 1 by 5. Okay, his share is given 1 by 5. So how to calculate the total capital of new firm? Total capital of new firm is equal to new partner's capital, that is 60,000. 60,000 into the reciprocal of 1/5, his share, the new partner's share. So 60,000 into 5/1. So 3 lakh. 60,000 into 5, 3 lakh is the total capital of new firm. Okay, now what is the actual capital? How much did actually the three of them bring? We know Hari has brought 80,000, Nikhil has brought 50,000 and Soman has brought 60,000. So that is added, 80,000 plus 50,000 plus 60,000. So that is 1,90,000. Now let's find out how much is the goodwill of the firm which is hidden here. Okay, hidden goodwill, that is total capital of the new firm 3 lakh minus actual capital of all partners 1,90,000. So we get 1,10,000. 1,10,000 as the hidden goodwill. And how much should Soman bring out of this 1,10,000? His share, his profit sharing ratio 1/5. So 1,10,000 into 1/5, 22,000. So this is the way to find out the hidden goodwill. Now let's move on to the journal entry part. Okay. So first journal entry, he is bringing the cash, capital. So cash account debtor to Soman's capital. The new partner is bringing his share of capital. And now here, goodwill, we can treat it in any way under revaluation method. No information is given in the question regarding how goodwill is treated. Like, is he bringing it actually? Is he able to bring it? No information is given in the question. So you can give the answer, give the journal entry in either way. Either you can write goodwill account debtor, full value of goodwill can be raised, okay, as there is no goodwill exist in the balance sheet. In that case, you can consider it any way. There is no compulsion. But the only thing is you should give a note when you give the answer. So for the accountancy exam, I suggest all of you, whatever method, whatever is your intention of giving your answer, you give a note. No need of so much of grammatical correct sentences, just give a note. This method has been used here. Okay. So to be on the safer part, it is the best thing to do. Goodwill account debtor, either we can raise 1,10,000 completely in its full amount and it can be distributed to the old partners in their old ratio, or we can take the situation as Soman will be bringing 22, Soman has to bring 22,000 but he is not bringing it, so we adjust it from Soman's capital. Am I clear? Did you get me what I meant? Okay. We studied various cases under revaluation method when the goodwill amount already exists in the book. If it is not there, if he is bringing only a portion of the goodwill account, what to do? Already a goodwill exists in the balance sheet. There are various cases, four cases we discussed under revaluation method. So according to your logic, you can decide a which journal entry to give, but only thing is you should give a note of it. As in the question, it is not specified which method to be used. That's why I am explaining this. Alternate journal entry means you can write it in your own words. Like, we can also treat it this way. When you give, write the note, write it near somewhere, somewhere in the margin you give. This in this method means we are raising the full value of goodwill in the old ratio. This method means the Soman's new partner's share of goodwill, he is not bringing it, so we are adjusting it out of his new partner's capital account. Okay. Is it over? Tomlin, finish.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Please switch on the video. Anjo, Anila, Basil. Okay. Now let's see. Next, we are moving to another set of accounting treatment. So these are all the accounting treatments that we do during admission of a new partner. Admission in the sense reconstitution is taking place. When reconstitution takes place, now we are discussing about admission of new partner. So when admitting a new partner or at the time of reconstitution, what did we do? We learned how to handle with capital of the new partner. When capital is brought, cash account debtor to capital account. Okay, cash account debtor to new partner's capital account. Now, then we studied calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Yes, calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Then we learned the sacrificing ratio. Yes, remember? Yes. Now we discussed treatment of goodwill. What is goodwill? Methods to calculate goodwill. Treatment of goodwill. So, four accounting treatments are over by now. Now, next I am going to discuss about the sixth one, not the five, sixth one. Adjustment of accumulated profit, reserves and accumulated losses. Okay, we are going to see the next top, next accounting treatment on admission, that is adjustment of reserves, accumulated profits and losses. How do we adjust the reserves, accumulated profits and losses, accumulated losses? Tell me, what are reserves? What are reserves? Yes, tell me, what is reserve? Anyone? What do you understand by reserves in accounting? Anyone? Tell me another situation in your life where you hear the word reserve. Anjo? In your life, what is reserve? Yes? No answer. Anyone? Reserve. Kartik. In your daily life.
Some amount of money.
Yes.
Kept aside. Some percentage of money kept aside and not used.
Yes, you know the answer. Then why are you not telling me the answer when I ask? Right. That's right. Okay. Reserve means from the profits that the company gets. The company is making profit. All the business, the main objective is to make profit. Out of the profit, a certain sum of amount, money is kept aside to meet something in future, either for some particular purpose, specific purposes, or just for safety, to be on the better side, safer side. We set aside some amount. That is called reserves. Okay. Can anyone tell me the types of reserves you know? These are all 11 standard portions. Yes, reserves. Is anyone giving me the answer?
Capital reserves.
Yes. General reserve, specific reserve. Have you heard of it? General reserve means for any general purpose. There is no particular intention. We keep it aside for general purposes. Anything. And specific purpose means particularly for something. Okay. Reserves. And talking about, here I have given the meaning of reserve. When an enterprise earns a profit during the end of a year, a certain part of it is retained in the trading concern to meet future exigencies, growth outlooks, etc. That means future requirements, something in future, future needs, unexpected, not planned. The amount of money that kept aside is known as reserves in accounting. When you ride the bike or vehicles, you say, now it's in reserve. Yes, do you use the term there? Petrol, it is reserve now. No? That is not used. That means what? A little portion of liquid, I mean the petrol, is kept as reserve in the vehicle when there is, the petrol is going to finish. The vehicle takes the petrol from the reserve, isn't it? Am I right? Okay, similarly, we keep aside out of the profit a few amount. Okay, they assist in securing the financial situation of an enterprise and can be utilized for different purposes such as stable dividend repayment. Dividend, we'll come to it. We are going to learn everything in company accounts. If the company, if the business wants to pay dividend to its shareholders, they can make use of this reserve. Out of this reserve, they'll give the dividend. Then, meeting contingencies, unexpected case situations, legal requirements. If anything related to government, they go for it and they need to make payment for the legal requirement, they take it from the reserve. Investments. Okay, it's time now, we'll find up. So, this is just an introduction about adjustment of reserves, accumulated profits and losses. See you in the next session. Okay, see you.